Hebrew, born of Hebrews, circumcised on the eighth day. He rattles off all these things. The tribe of Benjamin, that somehow that was special. And then he says, not only did I have this ancestry, this genetic predisposition, you might say, but when I became a person with my own sense of making good decisions, I was zealous for the law. I was even so zealous I became a Pharisee. Those were the little law Nazis. Boy, follow all the rules, and that way God will accept you. And he was so zealous about that, then, of course, he was persecuting the church. Those people who had given up, so to speak, given up their Jewish faith to become Christians. Blameless under the law. But what does he say? Whatever gains he had, he counted them as loss. He even uses the word rubbish, which might be even a more coarse word than we can say here. Rubbish, counted it all as loss. Paul realized that the old was not enough. The old way of doing things was never meant to be enough. He needed the new. And the new is what Jesus had achieved and now provides for anyone and everyone. Paul calls it the surpassing value. Surpassing. The surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. Paul is giving up the old in order to embrace the new. That's what he means when he wrote, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, which is the old way, but one that comes through faith in Christ, which is the new way. Now, Paul knew that the law was not worthless. It had its place. God had intended the law to be there and use it for centuries to guide God's people. You can read in Romans 7, 8, and 9, a very complicated discourse of Paul trying to help people understand the law had its place. The people of Israel have their place. But the law was temporary. It was always meant to be temporary. It did its job. And now the law, the old way, was being fulfilled in Jesus, the new way. I think in each of us, in our own journeys of faith, I think we are challenged with both of these. I think we flip-flop back and forth between the old and the new. I suspect that even in the back of our minds, we can catch ourselves sometimes thinking something like this: God accepts me because I'm good. God accepts me because I do nice things for other people. And that's the old way. Right? It's the way that Paul is politely setting aside because of the new way. And even the season of Lent could confuse us about the relationship between the old and the new. Because after all, Lent calls us to do things, right? Lent calls us to pray in a little more intentional way, to fast at least a little bit, to help us realize that God is there. We should desire God more than anything else we desire, right? And also to help others. These are all things we do, and it could be real easy to think in the old way. I gotta do these things so God will accept me. But Jesus is the new way. Now sure, God wants us to be good, but we don't do good in order to make God love us or to earn God's favor. We work at goodness because we're grateful to God, because God accepts us and forgives us and dwells with us. The old way has been fulfilled in the new. Last week, one of my brothers, I have three brothers, we have a text string going. He said, hey, you guys still have that old portable record player that Mom and Dad bought for us Christmas years and years ago. That was an enormous big deal because I guess everybody goes to a phase where they love music, and Mom and Dad never bought anything for all four of us at one time, partly because we didn't hardly have the money, see, but they went for broke that one year. It was a Sears Roebuck, and it was all mostly plastic, and it had kind of a clamshell design, so it went up like this, and then the two clips went up, and then back here were the two little loosening curve parts, and they could kind of dropped down so the top came off. Well, the top also split in two because the top was the two speakers. set them out. They had about 2 feet of cord, and then the rest of it was right there, and you could play records. There was even a little radio. Of course, it all depended on how good the reception it was in that time. You could play LP records, 33 and a third revolutions per minute. If you got one of those little adapters about the size of 50 cent piece, you could do the 45s or buy those one-hit wonders, right? So my brother asked, "Hey, do you still have it?" And I was very excited to say, "Yes, I still have mine, and I also have a few LPs that I could play on. That's the trick, isn't it? Because I haven't played it in years. And part of the reason is I don't have to. Because what we have now works so much better, doesn't it? The old has been superseded by the new. And when it comes to our faith, that's also true. And so during this Lent, as we walk this new path with our gracious God, let us remember what the psalmist reminds us of. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad indeed.
Decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world. us can humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against thee in thought, word, and deed,
by what we have done
and by what we have left undone.
We have
not loved thee with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent.
For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ,
have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in thy will and walk in thy ways to the glory of thy name. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear the word of God to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit. Good morning and welcome, everyone. It's wonderful to see you guys here. You'll have to help me as we go along because we're going to talk a moment about Holy Week. So next Sunday is Palm Sunday, and it is our plan to begin the liturgy, depending on the weather, either outside this red door in our circle drive or in the parish hall, depending on if it's cold, hot, rainy, whatever. And we will find our way in here and complete our service. During Holy Week, we'll have services on Thursday, an event on Friday, and of course on Sunday. Thursday at 6 is Maundy Thursday, which will include Eucharist. Our worship offering Friday is Stations of the Cross at noon, which will be here, and you're invited to either follow as we go along or sit and meditate and listen and pray as you hear the offerings at each of the stations. Saturday is a time at home for prayer and reflection. And Sunday at 9, we will have our first Easter service. We have an Easter egg hunt at 10. Bring your children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren. When you drive by your neighbors, pick their kids up and bring them too. Might have to ask permission first, but, you know, plan to do that. And then our second service at 11, followed by our first big homegrown coffee hour and reception. We'll have cake. You're invited to bring goodies from home that do not have to be prepackaged in cellophane. So we'll be happy to have that Easter celebration. Does that sound on target?
You covered it all, isn't it?
So this Wednesday, the Needlers are going to start putting the goodies in the Easter eggs. So if you do have something else you want to bring for next Sunday, we'll have time to finish those up too. So thank you all. Anything else with that? If so, we'll figure it out as we go along.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name. Bring offerings and come into his court. times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, because thou didst send thy beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may, without shame or fear, rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
All glory be to thee, O Lord, O God, for that thou didst create heaven and earth, and didst make us in thine own image. And of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him, and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. He made there a full and perfect sacrifice for the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue, a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to thee, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, we thy people who celebrate and make with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having remembrance and blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and his glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again with power and great glory. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and with thy word and Holy Spirit, to bless and sanctify these thy gifts of bread and wine, that they may be unto us the body and blood of thy dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, which whereby we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies. Grant, we beseech thee, that all who partake of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and also that we and all thy whole church may be made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom